And time waits for no one, no favors has he. Time waits for no one, and it won't wait for me. Now, one of the things that I've talked about time and time again, pardon the pun, on this channel is the idea of metaphorical truths. Another way of saying a metaphorical truth is a wisdom truth or a symbolic truth or even a spiritual truth, if you will. At the very least, what a Bible actually is. You say to me, Craig, I don't believe it's the Word of God. That's fine. But the very least what a Bible actually is, and there's no debating this, is the collective spiritual wisdom of a group of people in time and place. Matter of fact, that's what all spiritual texts are. Koran, you know, Tao Te Ching, whatnot. It is the collective spiritual insights, the collective wisdom of a group of people in time and place. Bearing that in mind, let us prayerfully consider our Bible, or it is possible to prayerfully consider your Bible and glean insights, glean wisdom from the content therein, if and you were so inclined. So let's examine some of the wisdom truths contained in the Bible. Wisdom truth number one, time is extraordinarily important. Time waits for no one, no favors has he. Time waits for no one, and it won't wait for me. Yeah, that's the Rolling Stones. That's actually one of my favorite Rolling Stones songs. That song used to haunt me. Honest to God, used to haunt me when I was 27 years old. And I was living at home and really honestly didn't know what I was doing with my life. I would play that song a lot. And it would actually start to really get deeply inside of me and kind of make me go, is this song saying something deeper than I'm actually hearing? But anyways, so time is extraordinarily important. The Bible underscores this often and frequently. Here's just one of the ways. Redeem the time, for the days are evil. Same Bible tells you to count the cost. Count the cost. Did you know it said that? Probably not. Count the cost. What does that mean? It means everything you do in life. There is nothing more valuable in life than your time. We tend to overvalue money in this society and not value time as appropriately. You can lose money. You can waste money. You can burn through money and you can get it back. You burn through time. Guess what? You ain't getting it back. It's extraordinarily valuable. And how you spend your days is extraordinarily important to your future success. More, probably more important than any single thing you can do is lighting your time correctly, making your steps right in terms of what you are trying to achieve in life. No more valuable asset you have than time. Nothing slipping through your fingers faster than time. So how you spend your time, how you prioritize your time, is perhaps the most important wisdom truth that you can consider. It's possibly the most important thing you can think about. Most people don't really give it that much of a thought. They do whatever comes in front of them. Why? Because, well, first of all, let's talk about counting the cost. What does that particular scripture mean? It means simply this. Every single thing that you are doing in life has a cost. At the very least, it has an opportunity cost. An opportunity cost, potentially important, that you should examine. What could I be doing with this time, this extraordinarily valuable time, that I have very limited, that I don't have infinite amount of resources on? What am I doing with this time? Could I possibly be doing something with this time that would be of more benefit to me, either in the long or even the short run? That's an opportunity cost. I'm doing X tomorrow. What could I be doing with that time? Is there something I could be doing that is different that would benefit me a lot more? Opportunity cost. Every single minute you spend doing something has a potential opportunity cost. Sometimes it's ginormous. It should be examined by you. In the context of a business, it's a lot easier to understand, for example, a wise steward of time. What is the goal of a business? Say, John Buck. Yeah, John Buck and I are building a company. We're going to call it Craig's Gizmos and Gadgets. as I've said in my past videos. We're going to sell gizmos and gadgets to imbeciles. We're going to make millions of dollars. Now, in the context of a company, it's really easy to understand prioritizing effectively the time of you and the employees. You know, what are you doing to maximize your profits in the short term and maximize your profits in the long term? It's easy to understand. The context of a life, that's where it gets a little dicey with people. See, if you, the individual listening to this, do not have some sort of meta-narrative for your life, some sort of overarching sense of purpose. It can be vague, but if you do not have an overarching sense of purpose, you're going to have a tendency to fritter your hours away and not really build anything for the long term. I believe Pink Floyd says it thus, ticking away the moments that make up a dull day. You fritter and waste the hours in an offhand way. That's what they said. That's what you tend to do. I remember hearing that song when I was like 16. It spoke right to where I was. The part where it goes, and the sun is the same in a relative way, but you're older and shorter of breath and one day closer to death. That's what tends to happen. If you do not have an overarching meta-narrative for your life, an overarching sense of purpose, you tend to spend your time frittering it away at what satisfies you in the short term. Now, I'll go into this in more detail in other videos, but the long and the short of it is the existential crisis that most people face in their life is that they did not keep track of how quickly time flows away. Time flows through your hands. And you turn around. It's what they call the midlife crisis. You turn around one day and you start going, gee, what am I building for? What am I actually doing? How am I actually valuing? What am I actually using the hours of my life to consciously do? Just a thought. It's a lot easier for you to prioritize your time effectively if you have some overarching sense of meta-narrative, some overarching sense of purpose. Again, can be vague. I want to be a big movie star. Okay, that's kind of vague. You know, I'm sure I could be a really big movie star. I just gotta, you know, just gotta get out of this place. Okay, that's kind of vague. But you can actually have a vague overarching sense of purpose and start heading forward in the here and now. Just a thought. I'm just trying to say this is what wisdom truth number one in the Bible. Redeem the time for the days are evil. Consciously try to spend your time. Everything, all activity you engage in has at least an opportunity cost. It would be in your best interest to make yourself more aware of how you actually spend your time and point it in a direction that serves your overall sense of purpose. I guess that's all for now. Amen.